Myself, Rushali Pagare, Faculty of Mathematics in KKVAG Polytechnic, Nasik, invite you to study the chapter of partial fractions. Today we'll see the case in which the denominator contains linear non-repeated roots. Let us see the first example, 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2. We'll name this fraction as P of x upon Q of x. P of x is equal to 1, which is a constant, so degree of P of x is 0. Now Q of x is equal to x plus 1 into x plus 2. If we multiply these two brackets, we get the highest power of x as 2. So degree of Q of x is 2. Now degree of numerator is less than degree of denominator. So, it is a proper polynomial fraction.
Observe the denominator Q of x. It is equal to x plus 1 into x plus 2. It is a product of two linear factors. Why linear? Because the power of x in both of them is 1. And x plus 1 is different from x plus 2. So, they are not repeating. Hence, the type is linear non-repeated. Now the fraction was 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2. So we'll split it up into two fractions. One will have denominator x plus 1 and other will have denominator x plus 2. Whenever the denominator is linear, the numerator should be constant. Here we have chosen a and b. You can choose pq, a1, a2, anything. So that will form our equation 1. Now do cross multiplication on right hand side. So we have a into x plus 2 plus b into x plus 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2. Observe the right hand side and left hand side. Both of them have same denominator. So they will get cancelled and we get 1 equal to a into x plus 2 plus b into x plus 1. One of the factors is x plus 2, equate it to 0. So we get the value of x as minus 2. Let us put this value of x equal to minus 2 in equation 2. So we get right hand side as a into minus 2 plus 2, that is 0, plus b into minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1. Hence we get the value of b as minus 1.
One more factor was x plus 1, equated to 0. So we get x is equal to minus 1. Substitute this value of x equal to minus 1 in equation 2. We get it as 1 equal to a into minus 1 plus 2 plus b into 0. Therefore, we get the value of a as 1. Now, put the obtained values of a and b in equation 1 to get the fraction as 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 2 is equal to 1 upon x plus 1 plus minus 1 upon x plus 2. So, we have decomposed our fraction into partial fractions.
Our second example is x upon x square plus x minus 2. Let p of x upon q of x be equal to x upon x square plus x minus 2. P of x is equal to x. The power of x is 1. So degree of p of x is 1. Q of x is equal to x square plus x minus 2. Highest power of x is 2. So degree of q of x is 2. Now the degree of numerator is less than degree of denominator, so it is a proper polynomial fraction. Now Q of x is given as x square plus x minus 2. Let us factorize it. We will get it as x plus 2 into x minus 1. Again, both of them are linear factors and both of them are different. So the case is of linear non-repeated type. So now, we have seen that the denominator is of the type linear non-repeated. So, we will split the fraction as a upon x plus 2 plus b upon x minus 1. Because there were two factors, so we split it into two fractions. And since both the fractions were linear, we will use constants a and b as the numerator. And thus, we will get the equation 1. Now, we will do the cross multiplication. Now, look at the left hand side, we will take the simpler form x upon x plus 2 into x minus 1. whereas on the right hand side we will do cross multiplication. So a into x minus 1 plus b into x plus 2 upon x plus 2 into x minus 1. Observe the denominators on both the sides are same, so they will get cancelled and we will have the equation 2 as x is equal to a into x minus 1 plus b into x plus 2. Now we will have to put some values of x in equation 2 in order to find the values of a and b. So what should we do now? One of the factor is x minus 1. So put x minus 1 is equal to 0. So x will be equal to 1. So put x equal to 1 in equation 2. We will get the value of b as 1 upon 3. Now again one of the factor is x plus 2. Put x plus 2 equal to 0. We will get the value of x as minus 2. Substitute this value of x as minus 2 in equation 2. So that we will get the value of a as 2 upon 3. Now substitute these obtained values of a and b in equation 1 to get the fraction as x upon x plus 2 into x minus 1 is equal to 2 upon 3 upon x plus 2 plus 1 upon 3 upon x minus 1. Is it clear? Hope you have understood. Thank you all.